In spite of the trials, in spite of the tribulations, in spite of the assaults by local officials that do not like how we practice our religion of providing shelter to the homeless, New Life Evangelistic Center is continuing to move forward. New and exciting things are happening, not only throughout the greater St. Louis area, but in Springfield, Missouri. Yes, God is moving in a mighty way. During the upcoming program, you'll get an opportunity to sit down with me and actually talk to a man that comes out of the hills of the Ozarks. Gonna play a little violin for you. In this shed, you're going to hear from people off the streets of St. Louis as well as individuals from Springfield, Missouri. Coming an exciting program, so I want to encourage you to stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. I have with me a man at this time who found himself homeless, living in his truck. Where are you from?
I'm from Shady Grove, Missouri.
Your family lived there on the farm for many years, didn't
it? Yeah, three generations. Both sides of my family go out to the field and jump around to the cows and things and up on the hill, and there's a great-great-great-grandfather.
And some years back, the government came through and put you all out?
Yeah. That's basically it.
And you were living in your truck for quite a while.
That's true, yeah. Uh-huh. But I got shelter now. I ran out of food is the thing.
And you're up here at our facility at 806 North Jefferson. How do you like this place?
Oh, it's really nice facility. You did a lot of good things here, you know, because there's a lot of veterans. Only 56,000 of us committed suicide. And we're about 29,427.95 suicide of the veterans. But
When were you in the armed services?
About 10 years, from 67 to 72 is actually when I was active.
Wow.
And, well, not 2 years inactive. And I was in Vietnam in 69 and 70.
So you're a Vietnam War veteran.
Yes, I'm a Vietnam War veteran.
Yeah, I see you got this fiddle in your hand here. I think you said you were going to do a little number for us. So go ahead.
Okay. I'll do a little Soldier's Joy, you know, which goes way. It's an old song. Goes back to you. Okay. Willie, my mother's daughter boy, my mother's daughter boy, Willie, my mother's daughter boy, sing a little song called Soldier's Joy. Chase the squirrel, chase the pretty girl around the world, buckle up, twirl, pass the jug around to Captain.
There's a lot of talent folks out on these streets out here. Thanks a lot for sharing that. Tell everyone your name again.
My name is John Robert Stubblefield.
And he found himself homeless. His family been living in the country for years and suddenly found himself living in a truck. Right. But here up at 806 North Jefferson at the New Life Evangelistic Center in Springfield. So how's the place helping you up here?
Very much. It's helped me. It's nice, clean environment, and food is... That's what I was.
There's a big help. You really
yeah, a big help.
Because you just really don't have money for food.
I know, I don't have money for food. Well, I grew up on a farm, you know, butchering hog and cow and chickens and growing our own gardens, you know, and playing with horse and wood stove, playing the banjo, fiddle, and the,
again, another aspect of homelessness, and we try to reach out to people from all over, and we're going to do this. Now, you know, when you do the work of God, the devil gets mad. But Jesus is Lord. And we've seen this oppression in St. Louis. But we're still doing an awful lot of work there, as well as in Springfield and throughout rural America. Way down in Van Buren, Missouri, helping a lot of people. Potosi, Missouri, other locations. But when people are hurting, we're reaching out through the love of Jesus, trying to help them. All because of those here that are sharing with the New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. All right, let's head to the streets of St. Louis.
Thomas Neely, and I've been homeless for a while now, and I've been trying to hoping that somebody get open again, like Reverend Rice or anybody that can come by where they can get us in somewhere. But we ain't none of us got nowhere to go right now, so all of us is looking for somewhere to go, but we don't have any place to go. That's what we're looking for, place to go.
Thank you. How's New Life helping?
Well, New Life is helping for everything because he tried to do anything he can to make it better for us. He always did. That one thing that we can say about Pastor, that he always tried to do the right thing. So we hoping that everything behind that makes something happen. That's all we trying to see. Thank y'all.
I'm back with John, and John, this is a painting you actually made for us, that you actually made for New Life, you made for me. Tell me, what did you want to show in that painting?
Well, I wanted to show 9/11/1956, which my family built the train station. It's sort of abstract. It was red, and they wouldn't give us electricity. We had to use hand tools, you know, we built them. We all played music, banjos and fiddles and mandolins, and then the train, see, the old ghost train, you mean, see, it was a side door down from Kansas City. We called it Marianne. So we had steam until 1956, and then they decided they wanted to take it out. So I just come in, and I loosened up the station there and took it out. But
you think you'd have pretty much figure that out for people to figure that out.
Well, I could go back into it. Well, I've been going abstract, you know. I can paint pretty realistically, actually.
Now you got something down, June 6, 1986.
1886. Yeah, that's when it went in, and 9/11/1956 is when it went out. And I was under federal appointment, you know, so we wouldn't have to pay a certain kind of tax.
So where was this train station at?
Cassville, Missouri.
Cassville, Missouri,
yeah.
Okay.
My family lived there for generations, but we live in the country.
Well, tell me, how's the big city of Springfield? Well, things are pretty different up here than they were down home, aren't they?
Oh, yeah, they have some real peculiar people here. I know, it's just one place. These guys are real friendly to me.
Uh-huh.
Cleo. A florist.
Yeah. So you're from back in the hills, is that
right?
Yeah,
I'm back in the hills. I'm rural all the way across America.
Mm-hmm. Well, like I said, we have all different kinds of people, each and every one made in the image of God, coming to us at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And, you know, the Lord has just called us to reach out through His love and to help whatever and in any way that we can. And I thank God for all of you that are making it possible so we can do just that. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. And, you know, I just want you to always remember, and I think you do, that Jesus loves you.
Yes, Jesus loves us, red and yellow, black and white. And
how's that helped you get through these hard times?
Well, I know that I can always pray, and when I was young, I got a pair of cowboy boots and a bicycle.
Okay, I'm right with you. Sometimes it's easy to feel pretty much alone, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, you can feel alone even in a big city, you know. Walk around and see millions of people and just feel really alone, you know, but yeah. I read the Bible every day. My granddad get up every morning. He'd sit there, and he made $1,000 his whole life. He'd sit there and open the Bible up, you know. And
kept on reading.
Always
read. Straight through the Word of God.
Yeah,
right?
Yes, sir.
Don't need a lot of money, just a lot of Jesus.
Yes, sir. Oh, yeah.
And that's where it's at.
Mm-hmm.
And so, again, God reaches out through His love to folks from all over, and He's called all of us to do the same thing. All right, let's go back to the big city.
Good afternoon. This is Rudy Boykins. I'm here to give information about the homeless situation in the city of St. Louis. There is a homeless location known as Biddle House. There's a lot of abuse going on that a lot of people are not aware of. This definitely needs to be exposed. They're mistreating homeless people when they're supposed to help them. Homeless people should get seconds, but instead those seconds are going home to feed the families of the staff members. I've noticed many things have been stolen, and these things need to be recovered. As a result of this, I'm taking my valuable time to reach out to my fellow citizens. If there's any help available, there's definitely people at the Biddle House who need it. We've been abused, we've been mistreated, and we don't want to be mistreated anymore. And this is occurring right at the Biddle House, where they're supposed to love us, where they're supposed to utilize tax dollars in the correct way. They're misusing funds. There are certain people there. I'm not going to name anybody, but the whole staff needs to be overhauled.
My name is Nathaniel Neal. I'm homeless, and I appreciate what Larry's doing. I miss the shelter because now I'm sleeping outside. One thing I see is things getting worse because it's supposed to be taking down the other two shelters, and we need somebody's help to help us out. I mean, we're all not bad people. So, I mean, if you can, put in a word to somebody and get us some help. Thank you.
Wherever you may be, whatever you may be in, God is right there with you. And we want you to know that He loves you. He's got a plan for your life. And so whether it's in St. Louis or whether it's in Springfield or down right back to the hills where folks may come from, we're there to reach out through the love of Christ because of all of you that are sharing with us. It's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. Now, John, you said you had another song you wanted to share, Prayer Bells in Heaven. Tell us about that song before you sing it. What does it do?
Every church, you know, has a bell.
Okay.
Usually, you know, right. We had a church. My great-granddad built with an old handsaw, which I used to cut wood with.
Tell us about that church, and that was back in the hills.
Yeah, it's back in the hills.
Uh-huh.
It actually was a Catholic church, but he wouldn't put a sign on it or a tag on it, you know, okay. So they would come in there, and we didn't think.
So it was a very big church, a little church?
No, it wasn't too big. Yeah, it wasn't too big.
So you didn't wait until the bell there, and you're going to do a selection on Prayer Bells in Heaven,
is that
right? Yeah. All right, we'll go for it, okay?
Well, as we are living in this world of care, many is the burden that we have to share. Well, probably will be Prayer Bells in Heaven going home for me. Prayer Bells in Heaven, oh, how sweet, sweet, and broken, where you all bound up on home. Jesus, our King, hear our burden now with burden and sin. God, not forgotten that there be sin.
You told me prayer meant an awful lot to you
All
that you've been through. How many years young are you?
I'm actually 69.
All right. So we can go back all the way back. You were, were you born at home? Where were you born at?
Well, I was actually born in a barn, yeah.
You're born in a barn?
Born in a barn.
Born in a barn.
I didn't fare too good in the city.
Uh-huh.
Even in a small city.
Right. So born in a barn.
Yeah.
All right, grew up out in the rural, out in the hills.
Some
point along the way, the family had the ground for generations, and then suddenly something happened with the government, put you all out, and you found yourself living in a truck.
That's what they done.
Out living
they
in
put
the
MX missile silo out there in the back 40, you know, and then they brought in the health food industry and threw us out.
There you are. Well, here he is now, and we're trying to help him along with many others here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, the largest walk-in shelter New Life Evangelistic Center has. Southwestern Missouri, northwestern Arkansas, particularly in the city of Springfield. Well, as we deal with issues here, and many folks from throughout rural America, we're still very much involved in the city of St. Louis. You know, they tried to give New Life Evangelistic Center 1411 Locust a cease and desist order, but it did not shut New Life Evangelistic Center down, it just expanded it. Our headquarters went from 1411 Locust to 2428 Woodson Road in Overland, Missouri. We have teams that are out on the streets of downtown St. Louis every day. We're working in a wide variety of ways, trying to find jobs for the homeless, places for them to live, and much more. So throughout Mid-America, New Life Evangelistic Center continue to working to be there when people are hurting, and that your gifts make all this possible. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, the 63166. I'd like to go to Zakiba Rudy at this time. Zakiba's going to talk some about something that urgently needs to be addressed. It's called LRA, Land Realization Authority in the city of St. Louis, 3,000 vacant buildings where all these people are homeless, 9,000 vacant properties, that's vacant lots, 9,000 vacant lots, 3,000 vacant buildings. Something needs to be done about this. Prayerfully, our state legislators will just cause LRA to release that property from land banking to really helping people that are in need where they can easily apply it and get it and get a home. Well, that's just one of many issues that we're looking at this particular time. Let's go to Zaki.
I'm here in front of St. Louis City Hall in support of New Life Evangelistic Center, call for, first of all, taking information for many of the homeless people that exist out here on the streets. As everyone know by now, New Life Evangelistic Center has been closed down, and I maintain that those who forced the closing of New Life Evangelistic Center have a demonic spirit. I want to get that out there first. Then secondly, in terms of I'm here in support of the call to make the Land Revitalization Authority much more effective in terms of with the number of blighted properties that they have throughout the city, which causes many eyesores in the communities, especially in North St. Louis in the black community, where LRA is the, one of the largest slumlords in the city with over 3,000 plus vacant buildings as well as 9,000 vacant lots. So in order to change that, then LRA has to step up to the plate and have a whole different policy where everyday citizens have greater access to purchase these properties to rehabilitate them as opposed to LRA using those properties and land banking them to eventually give them to developers who make millions of dollars off of these properties and then the citizens are not involved in that process. So I'm here in support of those efforts, and I want to commend the New Life Evangelistic Center for staying on top of trying to transform the negative conditions that exist in our community as well as helping the homeless.
I basically feel like if they don't give us the LRA buildings, we should just go in and start moving people in these empty buildings and just let them squat there. I know it take a little while to get them out, so at least they'll have some shelter for a couple of months. But you know, that's what I'm thinking. Let's just start moving them in.
My name is Fernando Teo. The VA's helped me out a lot because it gives me a place to come and get some food when I'm hungry. It gives me a place to wash my clothes. Gives me a place to take a shower. It gives me a place to actually an environment where I can be social, build relationships with other people who are facing the same circumstances as I am, so we can support each other and kind of work with each other through the struggle of homelessness. And it provides people with somewhere that they can also seek spiritual help. And counseling, and overall it's just a very positive environment that I'm glad exists, so that it's definitely helping a lot of people within the community who are experiencing a lot of different kinds of struggles as far as homelessness is concerned. And it's just a place where people can come relax, and also they have clothing as well. So it's actually, this is a really good thing that they got going on, and I'm so thankful that there are people who actually care enough about those who are on the streets and the people who are suffering and the people who have had experienced traumatic events, and they have a place to come to. And I know that it's our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ who is providing all of this, and he cares about people, and through his ministry we are saved, and I'm just so very thankful. I've been homeless for about 7 days this time. I was just actually living on a dairy farm milking cows. And yeah, you know, I came back to Springfield. This is where I grew up at. It's where I'm kind of from. And I'm just trying to start over. God is working the wonders in my life. And no matter what, even in the darkest of my times that I got to go through, I know that God is the light that's shining for my to light a path for my feet to walk down until I get back to the place where I truly belong.
Yes, I need all of you praying that we see this ungodly action of land banking thousands and thousands of properties, same time people are homeless, will stop in the city of St. Louis. But you know, New Life Evangelistic Center not only responds to the emergency needs of people, but it has long-term solutions. Ed Miles is a living witness of that. He was in our training program about 3 years ago. Now he's in his own place, and he's here in Springfield volunteering at our free store, 806 North Jefferson. Ed, how does it feel to help other people?
Beautiful. Like Larry Rice said, I'm from St. Louis, and I got started by the help of Larry Rice. He put me in a program, and I found the Lord and he opened my eyes, and now I think I'm doing pretty good. I'm doing better than I was.
Praise the Lord. And that's why we want to ask all of you to go to God in earnest prayer that we can get back into our 1411 Locust building immediately, as soon as we can. We're encountering a lot of principalities and powers and devil throwing obstacles out in front. Devil's throwing obstacles out there. Earlier, Zacchaeus was talking about the demonic as far as what they're doing. That's what it is. But greater is he who's in us than he that's in the world. And that's what we're doing, is we're trusting Jesus. And how is Jesus making a big difference in your life?
Beautiful. They say you ask and you shall receive. So I ask him in the morning and at night. And so far, it's been pretty good.
He answers prayer, doesn't he?
Unexpectedly.
What a mighty God we serve.
Yes, it is.
Well, we thank God for all of you that are praying for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. We thank God for all of you that are just letting the light and love of Jesus shine in you and through you. And I just ask you to continue to keep praying for us, because whether it's in St. Louis or Potosi, whether it's in Columbia, I can mention all these other places, Van Buren, out in Joplin and Marshfield, and just many, many other locations. God is at work because of all of you that are praying for us through New Life Evangelistic Center here. As I mentioned on numerous occasions, a lot of things going on here at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield. I'll let Joe tell you about that.
Hi, I'm Joe Batson. I'm the director here at the Veterans Coming Home Center in Springfield, Missouri. Coming up on June 10th, we're going to be having an open house here. We're going to be opening up to the general public, letting everybody know what all we do here at the Veterans Coming Home Center. Back in 2008, we acquired this building through the McKinley Act. The McKinley Act states that any federal property not being used should be going to the homeless. Reverend Larry Rice and New Life Ministries petitioned the government. They were granted this property, and we started opening up for veterans that were homeless here in the Springfield area. They did an annual usage report. There's a lot of square footage here in this building. They decided that it was large enough to have all of the Springfield area homeless here, so we changed it from the Veterans Coming Home Center to the Veterans Coming Home Springfield Homeless Outreach Center. So now all Springfield homeless area residents are welcome here at the New Life Evangelistic Center's Veterans Coming Home Center. Basically, what we do is we provide on a daily basis showers, laundry. We have a free store where people can come in and get free clothes. People use this as their address. If you're homeless, you don't have a mailbox, so that's hard to receive mail, so they use this address to receive mail. We have a telephone here. In case you don't have a phone, your government phone runs out of minutes, you can always use our phone. We have restrooms. It's hard to use a restroom in this town. A lot of people claim to be children of God and Christians, but yet they won't let you use their bathroom. We serve meals here twice a day, except on Sunday. Sunday we're open from 12 to 4. We encourage people to use church areas here, go to church. We also have a sitting area where people can come in and just sit and talk and relax. TV area where you can come in and watch TV. We have a computer area. If you'd like to come in, check your emails, go online, look for work. We have a rest area. If you've been up all night walking around because you're homeless, you don't have nowhere to sleep, you come in, you lay down and sleep here. We have locker space available here. If you have to carry your bags around, get wore out, we offer an area for you to store your clothes. You can come in, get a shower, change clothes, do laundry. It's kind of nice. We also have a library. We have a gentleman who's an old Vietnam veteran. His name is Wolf. He's been our librarian for a couple of years now. He's kind of pride of the library that he's put together here. And we have a lot of people that come in and get books out of there. That's pretty much what we do here at the Vet Center. If you'd have any questions or comments, you can call us here at 417-866-3363. Thank you.
The New Life Evangelistic Center is reaching out to many people. We just heard from Joe about all the things going on inside this building here to help people. How's it helped you?
It's given me shelter when it's been raining and cold. They've given me food when I've lived out on the streets, literally. They've helped us with, you know, being able to go to a church, having some of the churches come here and reach out to us. Like I said, I've now been clean, but I have lived on the streets, lived in a tent, so they have helped
us. So you were
into
drugs pretty heavily. You've come off of that.
Yeah.
What does Christ mean to you?
Oh, everything.
How is it helping you by trusting him to get clear of these drugs?
Because without him, I definitely would not be here today. I mean, because I could not have done it on my own. I pray every day, night and day.
That's good.
And I do believe that, you know, he's got some great plans for me, because there's no other way to explain the way things have happened for me.
God gives you give God the glory.
Yes, absolutely.
I'm out here at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri. Again, New Life Evangelistic Center reaching out in many different areas. But as we're working here in Springfield, we're seeing God just move, and we just give him the glory for all the things that he's doing as a result of all of you that continue to support the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. It's P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. I'm asking you to continue to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. There's a lot of need out there. And it's only through the grace of Jesus that we can see these needs met, right?
Absolutely.
And one of the things that's almost, you know, just the devil is so mad because so many souls are getting saved in St. Louis, they got us to cease and desist. But that's only temporary because God's making us strong in various areas, and we're going to come back. And we're going to see him do exceedingly abundantly beyond what we can even ask or think at 1411 Locust Street. And in the meantime, we're just seeing the Holy Spirit move in other areas, like here at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield. And we give God the glory. Now, you are surrendering everything to Jesus?
Absolutely.
How are you staying out of going back and out of sin?
Well, I go to Carol Jones, which is a recovery center right now, which helps a lot. And I've had to kind of cut off some of the people that I hung out with before. And, you know, like I said, I've been able to stay with a friend, you know, I call him my uncle, by the grace of God, since I've been clean.
And staying and coming here every day?
Coming here, yes.
That helps you, gives you Christian fellowship?
Yes, absolutely.
And that's what we want to do, is continue to be there, reaching out through the love of Christ, because of all of you that continue to pray and support this work.
My name is Jerry Wiggins, and I appreciate this, these bus tickets that Larry Rice has provided for us, because... Yeah, I appreciate these bus tickets that Larry Rice has provided for us, for the reasons that you might not be able to stay in one place at one time. Then you can take care of extra business that you need to catch up on, and I do. And I appreciate Larry Rice, and I hope you open back up, because I've canvassed for Larry Rice all over the city, and I recognize that he's well known, and people are very fond of him, and people do respect him very much. Ever since I was little, Larry Rice, he had my mother and my sisters and me and my stepdad, help us pay our utilities, and that saved us. And Larry Rice is a very good man. He's a very good man, and he never changed. And God is gonna help him, because he helped the child to hold to help others. And if you can, if you hear anything about Larry Rice, if you ever hear anything about Larry Rice, vote yes for Larry Rice.
They call it the Veterans Coming Home Center. It's a division of the New Life Evangelistic Center here at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri. God is reaching out. Many things are happening, and we just want to give him the glory. And I want to ask you to continue to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center as we're reaching out through the love of our risen Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. It's because of all of you that are praying for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center we're able to do this. Yes, we have many veterans coming to us here. We also have other homeless people that are not veterans, but, you know, they need help, so we're trying to help them here. So I do ask you to please continue to pray for us on a daily basis at New Life Evangelistic Center, as we're working to be there when people are hurting. Many different things that this work is doing, you'll find out about it if you'll go to www.newlifeevangelisticcenter.org and see for yourself all the ways that your gifts to New Life Evangelistic Center are having such a great impact on the lives of the hurting and homeless. By partnering with New Life Evangelistic Center, you know that you are making a definite difference for good in the lives of many. There's a purpose that God has been working through you, that God has provided for you. Now reach out and let that purpose flow through you as you partner with us to help many, many people all over mid-America. Again, it's New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. I thank God for each one of you that are praying, caring, and sharing at this critical hour.